This is a rematch of the 2018 contest. Political observers say Mosby won because Ivan Bates and Thiru Vignarajah split the vote. A wild card in this race is whether voters care about the federal indictment against Mosby. She maintains she's done nothing wrong.
Thank you. I'll make you proud.
People are desperate for change. There's an appetite for a clear vision and a true leader.
Thank you, guys.
Thiru Vignarajah spent Election Day pounding the pavement, handing out campaign flyers, and making its final arguments to become city state's attorney.
This era of lawlessness has got to end. From carjackers and killers to squeegee boys and dirt bikes, the city feels out of control. A state's attorney can bring it back under control, and I'm excited to do that.
Marilyn Mosby spending Election Day visiting polling places. She's pushing a list of accomplishments to voters, including reforming the criminal justice system, reducing racial disparities, and focusing on violent offenders.
It's a very clear distinction between me and my opponents. Both of them are running on going back to an era of zero tolerance policing, which created mass incarceration and police abuse. We cannot go backwards. We have to continue to go forwards. And that's what this election is all about.
I'm out here to grind.
Ivan Bates has never stopped canvassing. He says he's knocked on more than 15,000 doors in the race for city state's attorney. He's pushing his experience as a prosecutor and defense attorney. He says his focus will be on illegal guns and the harsh consequences of possessing and using them to commit a crime.
If you have an illegal handgun in Baltimore City, you're going to be held accountable and you're going to go to jail.
Mosby portrays herself as a progressive prosecutor. Political observers still give her the advantage because she's an incumbent. Reporting live from East Baltimore, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.